Okay, once again, good morning all. I think we can start our class on problems regarding Dolph Chebyshev array. Yesterday we have discussed the basic theory behind the Dolph Chebyshev array, and today we are going to do practical problems on Dolph Chebyshev array. So I think you might be remembering the theory we have discussed yesterday. We'll just go through the steps and we will try to apply it on the real problem. Okay, you can see, and you can just look at the slides. So before doing problem, we will just refresh what was the theory we have studied for this Dolph Chebyshev array. Basically, there is four steps. Okay, there are four steps basically. In first step, first what we have to do? See, we have discussed step by step yesterday. We first calculate the value of R ratio, main level maximum to side level level. That will be given condition. From that, we have to calculate R. What is R? Okay. Then next, select the Chebyshev polynomial. If the number of elements is n, we have to select n minus 1. Okay. I told yesterday, I explained how why we have to choose the n minus 1 degree. All that I explained yesterday. So just taking the points from that. First, you have to calculate the value of R. Next, select the Chebyshev polynomial based on the number of elements. Then choose the array polynomial. The array polynomial you have to choose based on the number of elements in the array. Okay, array polynomial has to be chosen accordingly. Then, for odd number of sources and for even number of sources, you have to choose the array polynomial accordingly. Then, equate the Chebyshev polynomial with the array polynomial and calculate the coefficients. That's all. So, these are the basic steps. Just keep these steps in mind while doing the problem. And I advise all of you to take your notebooks and write down the question and write down the steps of the problem in your notebook. Okay, so we will move on to the problems. So this is a question. First question we will do. Design a four-element broadset array of lambda by 2 spacing between elements. The pattern is to be optimum with a side lobe level 19.1 decibel down the main lobe maximum. This is the question. All of you please write in your notebooks and just message me once you complete it. Have you written? Just write the question. Yes. Okay. A few replies I got. What about the others? Okay, one thing I can assure you, I am going to check your notebooks if for a one day if classes are open, I am going to check your notebooks. There is no doubt in that. Okay, so that you can keep in mind. If there are no contact classes going to be happen, then you're safe. Otherwise, I'll be definitely checking your notebooks. So we have to solve. What is the first step? We have to calculate the value of R. Okay. So the pattern is to be optimum with the side lobe level 19.1 decibel down the main lobe maximum. So side lobe level below main lobe maximum in dB, that is given. Okay, that is given. That is 19.1 decibel. So that is nothing but the 20 log to the base 10 value of R. Okay. So we can just calculate side lobe level below main lobe maximum in dB is equal to 20 log to the base 10 R. So that is given. that is 19.1. So 19.1 is equal to 20 log to the base 10 R. Log to the base 10 R is equal to 19.1 divided by 20, that is 4955. Then R is equal to anti log to the base 10 of 4955. That is equal to 9.0157. You can take it as approximately 9. Okay. So first step is over. First we have to calculate the value of R. Whatever is given in decibel, that we have to convert it into number. Okay. So 20 log to the base 10 is given 20 log to the base 10 of R is given as 19.1 dB. Just find out R from that. Okay. So while I'm explaining, you can write it in your notebook. So first step is over. First step is a simple thing only. We discussed, first we have to calculate R. Okay. Have you written? Okay. Now, what is the second step? What we have to do secondly? We have to find the value of R. That is first step. Then what is second step? Second step, we have to find out the Chebyshev polynomial. Okay. We have to find out the Chebyshev polynomial. So you see, first step, calculate the value of R from the equation that we have done already. Next one is select the Chebyshev polynomial and find out the value of x naught just by equating t m of x naught equal to r, or you can use this equation also. R you already found out, then just select the degree of Chebyshev polynomial, that is m. You have to select, if m and r are available, you can calculate x naught by using this equation, or else by equating t m of x naught equal to r by the and solving in that method also, we can find out the value of x naught. So the next immediate step is finding out the value of finding out the Chebyshev polynomial. Okay. For that, what data is available in the question? For that, what data we need actually? In order to find out the Chebyshev polynomial, what data we require? What is the data required for that, for finding out the Chebyshev polynomial? No one is answering. What data is required for finding out the Chebyshev polynomial? M. Okay, M. M is required. Then how we will find out M? That is the question. M is required. M is the Chebyshev polynomial, the degree of the Chebyshev polynomial. How we will calculate that M, or from what data we can arrive at M? I explained yesterday. M depends on the number of elements. Okay. M depends on the, yes, n minus 1. Yes. Okay, M depends on the number of elements. So here it is given a 4-element broadside array. So number of elements is 4. If the number of elements is 4, we have to select, that means small n is 4. We have to select M is equal to n minus 1. One number less, that will be the Chebyshev polynomial. How that coming is, all those things I explained yesterday, you may be remembering, I don't know. Okay. So that we have to apply here. We have, it is given the distance that is equal to lambda by 2, that is not required here. And n, or number of elements, is equal to 4. So we should choose the Chebyshev polynomial of degree 3, that is 4 minus 1 equal to 3. Okay. And we have to equate that T3 of x naught equal to R in order to find out the value of x naught. R we have already found out. Okay. So hence we should use Chebyshev polynomial of degree 3. That t3 of x we have to find out. Okay. Then we have to equate t3 of x0 equal to r and find out x0. X0 we can find out either by equating t3 of x0 is equal to r, or we can use one formula given there. Okay. Based on your convenience, you can use. Okay, first problem we will do like this, and the second problem we will do the second method. Okay, any of these two methods, based on your convenience, you can use. So the Chebyshev polynomial of degree 3, I hope you are writing along with that. If you are feeling any difficulty, you can tell anybody. Okay. Then the Chebyshev polynomial t of x, we have to find out t3 of x. Then put t3 of x not equal to 0. That is the procedure. For that, we have to find out t3 of x. First, we have to find out what is t3 of x. What is the third Chebyshev polynomial or fourth Chebyshev polynomial? For that, we have to find out. So what is the general equation for Chebyshev polynomial? What is the general equation for Chebyshev polynomial? The general equation for Chebyshev polynomial, you see, that is, but dm of x is equal to cos m cos inverse x. That is the general equation. Dm of x is equal to cos m cos inverse x. So we have to find out t3 of x. Okay. Now to find out t3 of x, we will use the general equation. Here t is missing. T of x is equal to cos m cos inverse x. That is the general expression. From that, first we have to find out t0 of x. T0 of x, just put m equal to 0, that is cos 0, that is 1, that you obtained already. Okay. Then next, t1 of x, just put m is equal to 1, that is cos of cos inverse x, that is equal to x. Now we have t0 and t1. Okay. These steps we have done while explaining the Chebyshev polynomial also. Again, we are just explaining how to find out t3. Okay, so you have t0 and t1. Now we have a recursion formula that also we have seen earlier. Okay. For higher terms, we can use the recursion formula. That is tm plus 1 of x is equal to 2x into tm of x minus tm minus 1 of x. Okay. We have this recursion formula. So the same recursion formula we are using here. But for that, we have to find out t0 and t1. That is very easy. Finding out t0 and t1, that is very easy. So we have found out t0 and t1. Then we are using the recursion formula. What is the recursion formula? Tm plus 1 of x is equal to 2x into tm of x minus tm minus 1 of x. Okay. With this, we can calculate sequentially. T2 we can calculate, then T3 we can calculate. Okay. Have you written up to this? Yes. So just calculate T2 based on this formula. Just calculate T2. Just calculate T2 of x. What will be T2? T2 means m, you have to put m is equal to 1. So T2 of x is equal to 2x into T1 of x minus T0 of x. So what will be that? Just find T2 of x. Just try to do by your own, because this experience you won't be getting while you are teaching or you are studying by yourself. That's a problem with the problem. Okay, problems have to be done within the class itself, or at least you should understand during the class itself. Have you found out T2? this. What is T2? 2x square minus 1. Yes. 2x square minus 1. So T2 of x is equal to 2x into T1 of x minus T0 of x, that is 2x square minus 1. Then which polynomial we require? We require T3 of x. For T3 of x, again using the recursion formula. What will be T3 of x? Same, by using the same formula, put m is equal to 2. T3 of x will be equal to 2x into T2 of x minus T1 of x. Okay, that is 2x into 2x square minus 1 minus x. That is equal to 4x cube minus 3x. So even if you are using the textbook also, these steps are not there in the text. Okay, they will just skip all these steps in between and they will just move on to the final result immediately. So it won't be that much easy for you to understand this from the text. So if you want to understand, just like, please take a note of this and please listen to the class. Have you written up to T3 of x? Then what's the next step? We found out T3 of x. Now what to do next? Now we have to put T3 of x naught equal to r. R we already know, and find out the value of x naught. Okay, that we have to do. T3 of x naught is equal to r, and find out the value of r. T3 of x naught equal to r. That means just put x naught in place of x. 4x naught cube minus 3x naught is equal to 9. So what we have to do, just solve. This is a third degree equation. I think in your scientific calculator, you can solve this by using the Mohr equation. Up to third degree, you can solve, I think. Otherwise, you have to go for factorization method, manual factorization method. That is shown here. For factorization, just add and subtract 6x naught square. So 4x cube minus 3x. Okay, 4x cube minus 3x. Second degree term also we require for this factorization. So second degree term we are introducing 2 here, we are taking from here, and 2 into 3, 6. Okay, 6x naught square. We are subtracting and we are adding 6x naught square. So the polynomial value doesn't change. And then we are just 9x naught. Okay. Minus 9x naught and plus 6x naught we are adding. So that the total value will be minus 3x naught. Minus 3x naught, we are writing it as 6x naught minus 9x naught. This is for factorization. Okay. This 9 we are taking as the square of 3, and the 6 we are taking as this 3 into root of 4, 2, that is 6x naught. Right, so we are factorizing this. Okay. Then next, these factorization steps are explained here. So the entire polynomial can be written as 4x naught cube minus 6x naught square plus 6x naught square plus 6x naught, x naught, minus 9x naught, minus 9 equal to 0. Okay. And taking 2x naught square common from first two terms, you will be getting 2x naught square into 2x naught minus 3 plus 6x naught square minus 9x naught plus 6x naught minus 9. Okay. Then take 3x naught common from these two terms and 3 common from these two terms. So you will be getting, first term is same, second term will be 3x naught into 2x naught minus 3 plus 3 into 2x naught minus 3 equal to 0. So in all terms, this 2x naught minus 3 is common. Okay. That's why we are factorizing like this. I told you 2 into 3, that is 6, and square of 3, that is 9. Okay. Likewise, you should factorize. So 2x naught minus 3, we can take common from all the three terms. So it will be 2x naught minus 3 into 2x naught square plus 3x naught plus 3. Okay. So you may find it a little bit difficult, this factorization step, but there is an easy way. You can use that way also. That I will tell you later. First, we will follow the same procedure. So 2x naught minus 3 into 2x naught square plus 3x naught plus 3 is equal to 0. That means either 2x naught minus 3 is equal to 0 or 2x naught square plus 3x naught plus 3 is equal to 0. That means here this bracket is not there. That is there, printing mistake only. That's how we told, like in text, so many mistakes are there. So 2x naught minus 3 is equal to 0. That means x naught is equal to 3 by 2. That is equal to 1.5. Okay. And if you are solving this also, you are going to get. So we obtained the value of x naught as 1.5. Okay. Have you written up to this? Have you understood how to do the factorization and all? This factorization you are studying in the lower classes, but anyway, you are not expected to remember all those things. So if you are not understood, you did not understand this factorization, there is no problem. There is one more method. What is that method? Just use this equation. Okay, already we know the value of m. The value of m we already know. So x naught can be found out. R we know already. Here m is n minus 1, that is 3. Just solve this. But you have to remember this equation. But in the factorization case, you don't need to remember anything. Okay. You can just solve the equation in front of you. I think up to third degree polynomial, you can solve in your scientific calculator itself. You can solve and you can find the roots. Okay. If the polynomial is more than third degree, I think it's better to use this equation. X naught is equal to 1 by 2 into r plus root of r square minus 1 over raised to 1 by m plus r minus root of r square 1 over raised to 1 by m. This is a very simple equation to remember. Okay, r plus root of r square minus and r minus root of r square minus over raised to 1 by m. Okay. So just write down this equation and you can solve in your calculator this, and you can find out directly, you can find out x naught, or you can do for factorization based on your convenience and your wish. Anyway, we found out the value of x naught. Okay. So what is the next step? Next step is obtaining the array polynomial ET. Okay. Array polynomial ET we have to obtain. We have to obtain the array polynomial ET. So how you can obtain that ET? First question, it will be, what is the number of elements? What is the number of elements we are considering here? In question itself, it is given, what is the number of elements? How many elements are there? Four, yes. Four elements are there. So it which pattern we should go for, even or odd? It is even. So E T E, we have to choose E T E equation for E T E. E T E means there will be since there are even number of sources, we can use for, we can go for E T E. E T E means how it will be arranged. See here, odd number of sources and even number of sources are given, and we are told that we are having four elements in the array. We are having four elements in the array. Four elements means even number of isotropic sources. Four, how it will be arranged? Two on the left side and two on the right side. So how many coefficients will be there basically? Basically, only two coefficients will be there. A0 and A1. This A0 and A1 will there be in left side and right side. Okay. So in array polynomial, how many like elements we have to take? This is ETE. Okay. This equation only we have to apply. In that, we require only A0 and A1. So we have to choose first two members. Or we can say that k equal to 0, we can choose, and k equal to 1. Okay, that is only enough. Since there are only four elements. Four is an even number. So two elements will be there on the left side, and two elements will be there on the right side. So A0 will be on both sides and A1 will be on both sides. So total four elements will be there. Okay, so we need to find out A1 and A0 only. So otherwise we can say that k is equal to 0 and k is equal to 1 only we need to put in this equation. Okay, and we can take the set representation accordingly. Okay, so that only we are going to do. E4 can be obtained by putting k is equal to 0 1. E4 means ETE. Okay, ET, the total field, E for the even number 4. Okay, so ETE is equal to k is equal to 0 to k is equal to n minus 1. This is the general expression. In that, we need A0 and A1 only. So just put k equal to 0 and k is equal to 1. So k is equal to 0 and k is equal to 1 means we will be getting first two terms only. The first two terms means A0 cos IB2. What will be the z representation for that? Z, directly put z is equal to cos psi by 2. So first thing will be A0 into z. Second, A1 into cos 3 psi by 2 or cos cube psi by 2 minus 3 cos psi by 2. Okay. So based on that logic, these things and all we have explained yesterday. So 4z cube minus 3z. So these two terms completes our array polynomial. Okay, the array polynomial will be having only two coefficients, A0 and A1. So coefficients correspond to A0 and coefficients correspond to A1 is only required. Okay, have you written up to this? So E4 can be written as E4, our array polynomial. Since there are four elements, our array polynomial E4, in that A0 and A1 only required. Okay. So E4 is equal to A0 into Z plus A1 into 4Z cube minus 3Z. So we have found out E4. Okay. What was the next step? First step is to find out R. Second step is to find out x naught from Chebyshev polynomial. By solving the Chebyshev polynomial or by solving the equation, we can find out x naught. Second step, the third step is finding out the array polynomial E. since here even number of elements were there, we have to find out E4 we already found out. Then the next is just equate array polynomial and Chebyshev polynomial. That's all. This is the final step. Okay, just equate both. We have to equate our array polynomial is E4. Our Chebyshev polynomial is T3 of x. We have to equate E4 and T3 of x. E4, we are equating it with T3 of x. What is E4? E4 is A0z plus A1 into 4z cube minus 3z. That is equal to 4x cube minus 3x. Okay, have you written up to here? Have you written up to here? Up to 4x cube, yes. So in that z we are equating with x, but what is z? We have told yesterday z we are normalizing. Okay, we are normalizing x with x naught. So z is nothing but z is equal to x by x naught. Okay, so substitute the value x by x naught in place of z in this equation. So we'll be getting A0 into x by x0 plus A1 into 4 into x by x0 all cube minus 3 into x by x0 equal to 4x cube minus 3x. Okay, I hope you have written up to here. Then what is to do next? Equating similar terms. That means here you see one third degree term is there. Here also one third degree term is there. Here two first degree terms are there. Okay, x. Here also x. Here one first degree term is there. So you just rearrange the equation on LHS into one 3 degree term and 1 first degree term. Okay. That will be like 4a1 into x by x0 the whole cube plus x into a0 minus 3a1 by x0 equal to 4x cube minus 3x. You just rearrange the equation on LHS, you just rearrange 1 third degree term and 1 first degree term. Okay. And then compare on both sides. First degree term on both sides you can compare, and second degree term on both sides you can compare. That comparison is shown here. First, the first degree terms. After rearranging, the first degree terms are compared. On right hand side, the first degree term is minus 3x. So the minus 3x here, first degree term means there x we are taken as common. Then what is left over here? A0 by x0. Here what is left over? Minus 3 into a1 by x0. So x we have taken as common first degree term. X into a0 minus 3a1 by x0 is equal to minus 3x. Okay. So x and x will get cancelled on both sides. So a0 minus 3a1 is equal to minus 3x0. And the value of x0 that we already know. X0 is 1.5. Just put the value of x0 there. So we will be getting a0 minus 3a1 is equal to minus 4.5. Completed. So next, you compare the third degree terms on both sides. Third degree terms are there. Just compare. That means 4a1 into x by x0 the whole cube is equal to 4x cube. Compare like that. 4a1 into x by x0 the whole cube is equal to 4x cube. Just compare. From that, x cube and x cube will get cancelled. Then 4 and 4 will get cancelled. We will be getting a1 is equal to x0 the whole cube. That means x0, the value of x0 we already know. That is 1.5. 1.5 cube means 3.375. Okay, a1 to obtain the value of a1. And here we have an equation with a0 and a1. Once you obtain the value of a1, just substitute back in that equation. Okay, just substitute value of a1 here so that you will be getting a0. So a0 is equal to minus 4.5 plus 3 into 3.375. That is 5.625. Okay. Yes, 3.375. So a0 you are getting it as 5.625. So our problem is done. Okay, a0 we found out and a1 we found out. So the array of four sources is given below. A1 will be on leftmost side, then a0, then the middle center will come. After that, a0 on right side and a1 on rightmost side. So we have a1 is equal to 3.375, a0 is equal to 5.625, then 5.625 and 3.375. But the problem is done. But one more thing we have to do, that is equate this. See, you see this fourth point. That was the last step. Equate the Chebyshev polynomial with array polynomials and calculate the coefficients. And take ratios for relative amplitude or just normalize with the farthest element amplitude. Okay, we have to just normalize these things. Okay, because we have to keep the ratios as small as possible. So already we obtained this as 3.375 and 5.625, 3.375. What is to be done? Take ratio with the amplitude of the farthest element. Or what is the farthest element here? 3.375. And here also that is 3.375. Just divide all the elements with amplitude of farthest element. Or just divide all with 3.375. That is shown here, the relative amplitudes. A1 by A1. Or 3.375 by 3.375. That is 1. Then A0 also you divide by 3.375. That is 5.625 divided by 3.375. That the answer will be 1.66. Okay, So the relative amplitudes will be 1. Okay, A1, that is 1. Then comes A0, that is 1.66. Then the middle portion will come after that. First element towards right, that is again A0, 1.66. Then the farthest element, that is A1, that is 1. So the ratios of amplitude will be 1:1.66:1. Okay. So that only shown here. A1, 1, A0, 1.66, then again A0, 1.66, then A1, 1. Okay. So these are the relative amplitudes. So in like in place of putting this 3.375 and 5.6 and all, we can just achieve the same by using 1 and 1.66. Okay, that's why we are taking this ratio, or that's why we are normalizing. Okay, I hope you completed this. Have you completed? Okay, then we will just go through one more example. This was even number of source, and the second one we are dealing with odd number of sources. Okay, and we will do the different methods in some places. Okay. So this is the first skill. Determine Dolph Chebyshev current distribution for the minimum beam width of a linear phase broadside array of 5 isotropic unit sources. The spacing between the sources is half wavelength and the side lobe level is 20 dB down. So just write down the question. Just write down the question. Completed. Have you completed? So the procedure is same. The procedure here it is the same. Okay, side lobe level below main lobe maximum in decibel. That is 20 log to the base 10 R. That is given 20 decibel. So 20 is equal to 20 log to the base 10 R. So R will be what? Just do the calculation. Log 10 to the base R is equal to 20 by 20. That is 1. So R is equal to anti-log of 1 to the base 10, that is 10. So R we obtained 10. In the previous question, it was 9. Okay, so here it is 10. Just like again, we just write it a bit fast because the steps are same only. Only some difference is coming in other calculations. There only we are going to give more emphasis. Okay, here this are all we have done already, and they will be familiar also. Okay. So the value of R is 10 obtained. Then what is the next step? What we have to do next? Yeah, M. How we will calculate M? How we will calculate M? Or what is the value of M here? Just type what is the value of M. Oh, yes, Ambali, correct. Okay, Shahina, Shilini, okay, 4. So, 4. the value of, okay, I'm getting so many replies. Good. So n is equal to 5. Okay, so m is 5 minus 1, that is 4. So m is 4. So we have to find out t 4 of x, the fourth Chebyshev polynomial. Okay, how you can find out the t 4? Just use the recursion formula. Okay, just use the recursion formula. While doing in your note, you can do like that. Just use the recursion formula, because already we found out up to T3. For the last problem, we found out up to T3. Okay, so T4 is 2x into T3 minus T2. Okay, T4 will be 2x into T3 minus T2. Just use the recursion formula and you will be getting that as 8x raised to 4 minus 8x square plus 1. That is equal to r. So you have to solve this. Okay. T4 of x naught, you have to solve. So T4 of x, you are going to get 8x raised to 4 minus 8x square plus 1 equal to 0. That is T4 of x. So in order to find out the value of x naught, we have to solve T4 of x naught equal to r. Okay. So you can, so you have to solve this. Okay. 8x raised to 4 minus 8x square plus 1 is equal to 20. Or you can just, here you can see this is a fourth degree polynomial. So solving will be difficult. So here what we will do? We will do x naught by using this equation. We will solve x naught by using this equation. That is 1 by 2 into r plus root of 1 r square minus 1 all raised to 1 by m plus r minus root of r square minus 1 all raised to 1 by m. Okay. So m is equal to 4, that we know. R is 10, that we already derived. Okay. So what will be the value of x naught? X naught will be the solution of this thing. So this I can you can easily solve by using your scientific calculator. There is no need to take this log and all. Here they have taken this log and all in order to solve this more manually. But here you can directly, by using from this equation itself, you can solve it directly by using your calculator. Okay. So the solution part and all you can do. So this is the equation. X naught is equal to 1 by 2 into so and so. Okay. So by solving this, we'll be getting x naught is equal to 1.2925. Okay. X naught is 1.2925. Okay, I hope you can do the calculations later. Just write the general formula for x naught, that is x naught is equal to 1 by 2. This formula you can write, and the solution of x naught you can write. Okay. Now, what is the difference here compared to the last problem? What is the difference here? Here, the number of sources, what is the number of sources here? How many sources are there? Or how many elements are there? 5. Okay. So, in previous question, it was 4. So here it is 5. The difference is here the number of elements are odd. Okay. In the previous question, it was even. So here it is odd. So we have to use the expression for total field. E, G, O we have to use. Okay. So that expression we have to use. E, G, O or E, 5 can be obtained by putting K is equal to 0, 1 and 2. That is, you have to put it in the general expression. General expression we have discussed yesterday, ETO. See this one. Here, you see ETO is equal to K is equal to 0 to N AK cos 2K psi by 2. In the expansion, you can see A0. There is only one A0 will be there. Then A1 and A2. So, here, number of elements is 5. So how we can conclude that up to which value of k we should go, or how many values of a we have to find out, a0, a1, a2. Sometimes you can feel that you may get a feeling like that we have to find out up to a3, but here we are saying that a1, a2, and a0, only these three are required. How? Just look at the basic arrangements.
If sources are odd number, then the first element will be in the middle, that will be 2a0. Okay, then towards both sides elements will be there. So here number of elements is 5. That means a0 is fixed in the middle. That is fixed. Then we need two more members on either side. So we can say that we need a1 and a2. So we can say that we need to find out. We need to find out up to a2 only. Okay. So eto, we can take first three terms, a0, a1, and a2. That will be sufficient. Okay. So p5, that is a0 into z, the set expression we are taking, plus a1 into 2z square minus 1, plus a2 into 8z raised to 4 minus 8z square plus 1. And put z is equal to x by x naught. Z is equal to x by x naught. So we obtained our array polynomial E. We obtained our array polynomial E, that is E5, since 5 elements are there. Then the final step. What is the final step? Equate array polynomial to Chebyshev polynomial. So our Chebyshev polynomial, we found out that is 8x raised to 4 minus 8x square plus 1. Okay, array polynomial, we found out a0 into z plus a1 into 2z square minus 1 plus a2 into 8z raised to 4 minus 8z square plus 1. Just equate both and equate similar terms. Okay, you can, for the time being, you can just write e5 is equal to t4 of x. Okay, and e5 you can write, and t4 of x you can write, and substitute z as x by x0. x0, value of x0 is already known. And here these calculations you can do directly in the calculator. a2 you will be getting by comparing fourth power of x. Okay, fourth power of x on the right hand side, 8x raised to 4 is there. On the left hand side, only one term. Okay, that is a2 into 8x raised to 4. Okay, so a2 into x by x0 all raised to 4 is equal to x raised to 4. Like that, you can equate. From that, you will be getting a2 is equal to x0 to all power 4. x0 already. We found out at least 1.2925. Just take 4 power of that. You have no need to take logarithm on top. You can just take 4 power using your calculator. So you obtained a2. Okay. Then similarly, by solving, you can obtain a1 and a0. That solving part, you can do it on your own. Just solve for a1 and a0. Okay. So, while arranging, there is one particular thing you need to. Okay, there is one particular thing you need to take an extra care. That is, here the middle element should be 2a0. Okay, even though we obtained it as a0, that will be represented as 2a0 in the middle. Okay, that you have to take an extra care for that. All others you can write just
A1, A2 on right side, and A1, A2 on left side. Then what's the next step to take, next step to do? Just divide the entire elements with the farthest elements, or divide the entire array with 2.787. Just divide, you'll be getting 1, 1.6, 1.9, 1.6, 1. Okay. Thus, our array is completed. Okay. This is the design procedure for odd number of elements. So this A1, solving for A1 and A0, that you can do your own. So I think today we can stop here. Then next class onwards, I think we can move on to module 4. Okay. Thank you.